Hey guys, welcome to another video. Today I want to share about the gifts and the curses of sensitivity. So if you're watching this video, probably given that you're a very sensitive person, I know I am too, sensitive to all kinds of energies, environments, people, foods, you name it. In this video, it's important that I get across to you how much of a gift these sensitivities are, even though at times I know they can feel like such burdens and such a curse. A lot of the times our sensitivities can make us feel really overwhelmed by just everything. Other people's energy makes us feel super anxious. Big crowds, loud noises bring out lots of anxiety in us. Just certain situations, certain foods, certain environments, it can all make us just feel really challenged by all this, just the feelings we're dealing with. And that's obviously, we know the curse of sensitivity. It's that sensitivity can make us feel really limited. It can make us feel small because we don't want to deal with all of these feelings and energies that we are becoming so opened up to and exposed to. So the curse is pretty straightforward. Now the gift, the great part, the payoff, the reward of the sensitivities. The sensitivities are going to make us more intuitive. They're going to make us be able to connect on a deeper level with others, with ourself. First and foremost with ourselves, and then we share that connection with others. We're going to be able to just kind of gather the information in a room very quickly about what people are thinking and feeling. We can just tell just by looking at somebody where they're at emotionally and energetically. We are going to always have a knowing of the inevitability of our next step in life. And there are many times where this doesn't feel very clear on the spiritual path, because the mind and the knowing are different. The mind is gonna think it has no idea what's happening, because a lot of times all of this energy is going to confuse and overwhelm the mind. But there's always this place, if you get very still and very quiet, there's always this place deep within you, in your heart, that knows the next step to take. And that's another gift. And you're going to become more empathetic. You're going to have this ability to just hold space for those around you. You're going to be able to hold space for people that are in pain, for those that are suffering. And through being able to feel into what they're going through so much, you're going to know how to help them in a deeper way. Whether it's knowing the right thing to say, whether it's just really listening with such a depth that the other person feels so heard. That's a huge one for us who are becoming so sensitive, is we can understand when sometimes people just need someone to listen to them and to hold space for them. And we also know when it's the right time to really share insights and personal experiences with them to help people learn how to heal themselves. Those are just some of the rewards of being more of becoming very sensitive. I mean, with sensitivity, you become so connected to your own energies, and when this happens, you become more connected to that loving vibration. When you become more sensitive, what's happening is you're becoming more open. And as you become more open, you're opening up into higher consciousness, more awareness. So this means higher vibrations like love and joy and peace. All really beautiful things. Now I want to talk about how to really turn the sensitivities from a curse into where you're feeling overwhelmed into receiving all the beautiful gifts from it. This is the number one path to transform sensitivities from curses into gifts. It's simply to allow. The power of allowing is so incredibly transformative. When we start to allow all of these uncomfortable energies, emotions, anxieties, fears, when we start to allow the overwhelming nature of the sensitivity, what happens is we start to really know our field of our grid, our energetic grid, if you want to call it, our field of awareness. When we're allowing these emotions to come up, we really start allowing ourselves to know the depth and the expansiveness of our field of awareness. And what happens is, as we start letting these emotions up more and more, we start identifying less with the body and the mind. And we start to really know ourselves as this expansive and vast awareness. In my experience, this is because every layer of unease, anxiety, fear, depression, anger, you name it, what every layer of darkness that we consciously allow to come up, we deepen into our being. So every layer that comes up, we fall back into our space of awareness. It's another really good label for it. And as we come to know ourselves, and as we come to feel into the space of awareness, also, if you're a yogi or into yoga, it's called the subtle energy body. And it resides, anywhere from here to a foot, 6 inches out, maybe even you could go a few feet out, whatever resonates with you. But as we start to let go into this field of energy, this field of presence, and we start to allow the energies to come up, we start to become more, I don't want to say unaffected, but we start to become less attached to what we're feeling. We start to become less attached to the negativity that's coming up. And when this happens, when we're not attached to it and grabbing onto it and being pulled in by it, and giving all our consciousness, energy, and attention to it, and we're not being overwhelmed by the negativity and the sensitivity coming up. When this happens, we start to realize how, when we start to start not, when we start to not be so attached to this, we start to realize how free we are. And we start to realize how, when we can just let this energy come up, it doesn't overwhelm us, it doesn't obliterate us, and it doesn't destroy us like we kind of feel like it will, like the mind tells us it will. This energy just, you can call it one of two things. It either releases from our being or transmutes into balance, into a harmony. And it's hard at first because you're so stuck in the body and the mind, and you're so identified as with yourself as the body and the mind, that first layer, those first few layers coming up, are so hard to really allow, because there is a lot of you that is actually being obliterated, because the parts of you that think you're going to die when you let this intense energy come up, when you just totally surrender to it, those parts of you do die. And that's a good thing, because those parts of you are limiting you. They're limiting your ability to really cultivate the gifts of the sensitivity. So when you can let those parts of you just fall away, and you can start to know yourself as this space of being, as this subtle energetic body, that's when you can really allow for the energy within you to start coming to a harmony and a balance. And you do this by allowing the sensitivities, by allowing the fear and the darkness. You just let it come up. And you know that you are just so much more than the body and the mind, that you have, that this movement of total allowing whatever arises, just starts naturally unfolding. You only have to consciously allow the layers up for so long until it just becomes this automatic movement in you. There's a saying, at first you start chasing the divine, But then the divine starts chasing you. And how that applies to this example is, at first, yes, you have to consciously allow these energies to come up, and you have to really build your awareness to the point to where you don't get sucked into it. But then over time, these energies just start coming up, and there's already this movement in you that's so automatic. There's so much momentum to this allowing movement inside of you. It just becomes a constant process. It just becomes who you are. It's a never-ending meditation of allowing whatever is. And that's how you really turn all these sensitive feelings and emotions that feel so overwhelming. That's how you cultivate and churn them and transform them into gifts. And really, it's just about stepping into your power, and you step into your power by allowing. Allowing is the pathway to power, because allowing lets all the darkness that you're afraid of and suppressing, allowing really lets it all come up to be felt. And then you get to all the wisdom of the darkness, and the darkness is your power. So embrace it, love it, open to it, and allow what this darkness will do for you. If you allow it to come up, it will allow you to connect to your space of being, to your field of awareness, to your energetic grid, to the subtle energy body. Essentially, the darkness will help you to connect to what is in you that is beyond the mind and beyond the body. And that is the absolute primary movement of this awakening. And I hope this video has helped you to connect to that a little bit more. It takes time, it takes patience. Sometimes it feels like you're going backwards, you're never going backwards. Just stick with it, it will be worth it, I promise. I look forward to connecting with you all in the next video. Namaste.